guys, welcome back to the channel. Today I am making a beef stewed stroganoff. It's very easy to make. You don't have to have a lot of ingredients. What you're going to do is you're going to cook it for at least 45 minutes to get the stew meat tender. And let me show you what I'm working with and we'll get right into the recipe. Okay, to get started, we have 2 pounds of stew meat. I have gone ahead and cut this again. They had rather large pieces in with the package, so I went ahead and cut it again so it wouldn't take as much time to get tender. This is 1 large yellow onion that I have cut up. This is 2 pounds of mushrooms that have been washed and sliced. This is 3 cans, so 26 ounces of cream of mushroom soup. You're going to need at least that. 1/4 of a cup of heavy whipping cream, 2 tablespoons of olive oil, and then if you're using noodles, you're going to need this is a 17.6 ounce of egg noodles. This is German egg noodles. I've never had this before, so I wanted to try them out. But if you have a preferred brand that you want to use, you can use those as well. You can also serve this over a bed of rice, or you can serve it over mashed potatoes. So let's get right into the recipe and I'll show you how to do it. Okay, so in a large skillet or a large pot, you're gonna preheat this and you're gonna put 1 tablespoon of olive oil inside the pan. And you're going to reserve another tablespoon of that olive oil for later. Okay, after it's good and hot, we're going to put the 2 pounds of stew meat that I have here, and we're going to put it right into the skillet, and we're going to fry this up and brown it until it's good and brown, and then we're going to take it out and set it aside. Now what I'm going to do for this stew meat is I'm going to put a little bit of salt, onion powder, garlic powder, and pepper. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and put a little bit of pepper on the meat. Put about 1 teaspoon of black pepper. You're going to put 1 teaspoon of salt. Now again, I'll have all the measurements down below in the About Me section. I'm going to add just about 1 teaspoon to 1.5 teaspoons of onion powder. And 1 teaspoon of garlic powder. Okay, while this is frying up, you want to go ahead and get you a dish to spoon this out of and put on until we get the other stuff cooked. So go ahead and just toss this on high until it becomes brown on all sides, and it don't take long. Now mind you, this meat's gonna be cooking for 45 minutes, so you don't have to have it all the way cooked. So just go ahead and toss it, fry it up real good, and then after you have done that, go ahead and spoon it out and set it to the side. Okay, it looks like it's coming around pretty good here. It's almost done. Now what I want to do is get rid of this juice because I don't need it. So go ahead and just cook it until you get rid of all of that juice and you've browned all of your meat. Guys, I almost forgot one more ingredient, and that is the beef broth. So you're gonna need 1/2 cup of beef broth of your choice. It can be the Knorr that I'm using. I'm using Knorr beef broth. Or you can go and get you some low sodium beef broth if you are watching your sodium. But I made me up some Knorr bouillon in 1/2 cup of water. We don't want to forget that goodness, do we? Let's see what our meat is doing. Okay guys, it looks like our meat is ready to go. So I'm going to go ahead and take this out and put it on a dish so we can set it to the side. Now we're going to be putting all this back together once we cook the mushrooms and the onions. And we're going to do all this in the same pot. So you don't have to dirty a whole bunch of pots. The only other pot you need is for either your rice or your noodles. It smells so good in here. Now if you're like me, you like to season your meat really good, because I want some flavor to my food. And there you go. Plate of stewed meat, brown stewed meat. Let's put this to the side and we'll start on our onions and our mushrooms. Okay guys, now that I've got all of the juice from the meat out of the pan, I'm gonna go ahead and put in another tablespoon of olive oil. Okay. Then I'm gonna put my large yellow onion into the pan. And we're gonna saute this up until it is soft. And then we're gonna put in our mushrooms and cook them and brown them, and then we'll put everything together. So we're gonna toss this. And saute this. I love carameled onions. I don't know about y'all, but it just smells so good when it's cooking. And while these are cooking, I'm gonna go get me some minced garlic to put with this. Now this recipe didn't call for it, but I love flavor in my food. And I season my meat real good. I always put enough flavor in there to, you know, make people want the dish again. So you don't want your food to be bland. So let's go ahead and saute these up, and then as soon as they're soft, I'll put some garlic and some mushrooms. Okay, so the onions are just about done, so I'm going to go ahead and add in a half a teaspoon of minced garlic, and I'm just going to eye it. Let's stir that in with the onions until it becomes fragrant. Now I'm going to add in all of my 2 pounds of sliced mushrooms. And we're going to brown these with the onions. While you're doing this, you might want to get your water ready for your noodles or your rice cooking in your rice cooker if you have one, and get that ready to go once your stewed stroganoff is ready to serve. Okay, now that the mushrooms have gotten brown, I'm going to go ahead and add in my beef broth. And we're going to simmer this for a good 5 minutes, and then we're going to put the rest of our ingredients in. Go ahead and let that simmer for about 5 minutes. Okay, this has been cooking for 5 minutes and it's reduced some of the liquid. So now I'm gonna add in all of my cream of mushroom soup. This is 3 cans that equals out to 26 ounces of cream of mushroom soup. Okay. Now you're gonna stir this and mix it in well. Oh gosh, it smells so good in here. Thank you. Mix it in really, really good. Now I have reduced my heat to a medium low. And I'm gonna go ahead and get my stew meat. And I'm gonna put in my stew meat now. All of that stew meat goes right back into the pot. Stir it around, mix it up really good. Now you're gonna be simmering this until the meat becomes tender. So you're gonna simmer it on medium to medium low for 30 to 45 minutes. Now you don't have to use the stew meat if you want just beef stroganoff. You can use ground meat if you want. And then again, you know, if you have a lot of meat that's in big chunks, you can take the meat and cut it again, like I did, into little smaller pieces, and that way it will cook a lot faster than if you didn't cut it. Okay, now that that's mixed in well, I'm going to go ahead and add 1/4 of a cup of heavy whipping cream. And I want every bit of that cream. And you're going to mix that in well as well. Now you can taste it at this point. If it needs more salt, you can add more salt. I use the beef broth, the Noor bouillon, and it has enough sodium in it. And I seasoned the meat with salt and pepper, onion powder, and garlic powder. So I think I'm pretty good with seasonings. I didn't want to get it too salty. But if you're trying to watch your sodium intake, you can totally use the beef broth that's low sodium. You can use organic. Now, we're gonna let this simmer on medium low until the meat has become tender. And I'm gonna get a large cover and cover this up and just let it simmer on low for 45 minutes. And while it's cooking, go ahead and get your noodles ready or your rice. Maybe you're having some mashed potatoes with it. Go ahead and get your side dish, like some asparagus would go good with this. Anything would go really good with this beef stroganoff here. I will see you in 45 minutes. My water is ready, so I'm going to go ahead and put my noodles in. Okay, guys, this has been simmering for 45 minutes to an hour. And I just checked the meat, and it is ready. It is all nice and tender. Look at that. And my husband is gonna have a bed of jasmine rice. We had some left over from yesterday's recipe. And I'm gonna have mine over some German noodles. Oh, that looks so good. And it tastes absolutely delicious. So let me go ahead and plate this up, and I'll show you what it looks like after I'm done. Over here and get me some of these German noodles. These are egg noodles. Put some up here on my plate. Now let's get me some of this mixture here. Got my noodles. Look at this. Isn't that just amazing? Mushrooms and onions and stew meat. It's going right over the top of those noodles. Now you can serve this up with some mashed potatoes, or you can be like my old husband in here and eat it with some rice. Look at that. Absolutely delicious, guys. So I thank you so much for watching the channel today. Subscribe if you haven't already subscribed. Like and share the video. It helps my algorithm and get out to people that haven't watched the video yet. And I thank you so much for watching, and have a nice, lovely dinner. Thanks, guys. And until next time, I'll see you in the next video.